You are our God. You are our King. You are the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, wonderful God. Thank you, glorious God. Thank you, unique God. Thank you, Alpha and Omega. Worship Him. Let's honor Him. Let's reference Him. King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Jehovah Jireh, the Jehovah Nissi, the Jehovah Shammah, the Jehovah Rapha, the Jehovah Roy. Glorify yourself in the name of Jesus. Every covenant, every agenda, every plan of the enemy concerning the service of today, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. As we gather, Lord my God, let your presence make a difference. Let the heaven be
hope. Please don't you confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. So this morning, we are going to mention the name of the Lord. And if you are sick, if you mention this name, the Lord will give you the healing this morning in the name of Jesus. Yeah. If you mention this name, if you are down, Jesus, our Lord, calling you,
how I love.
No more. are lifted up
above all
above. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Great is our faithfulness, O Lord, my Father. There is no shadow of falling with thee. Thou shalt be the Lord, the compassion, the fear not.
I want you to honor him. I want you to reference him. I want you to adore him. I want you to magnify his holy name. I want you to thank him, exalt him. You make it to the second Sunday in the year 2022. Can you thank him and worship him? Can you exalt him? Can you give him glory the second Sunday in the year 2022? Thank him for life. Thank him. Thank him for what he has done. Thank him for what he's doing. Thank him for great and mighty things that our God is doing. Worship and honor. Reference and adore him. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Jehovah Jireh, the Jehovah Nissi, the Jehovah Shammah, the Jehovah Rapha, the Jehovah Roi, the Jehovah Adonai, the God that was, the God that is, the God that is to God, the God that have all power, the Supreme God, the mighty God, the wonderful God, the glorious God, the unique God, the God that never fails, the God that never changes, the God that never disappoints. We worship and honor you. We reference and we adore him in Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed.
Amen.
We are going to pray unto God. Say, Father, Have mercy upon me. Even today, in the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and begin to pray. As I cried unto you this morning, Daddy, have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon my house. Have mercy upon my family. Have mercy upon my children. Have mercy upon my house. Have mercy upon my work. Have mercy upon me. Let the God of mercy, let it be open. Even unto me, in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Keys. You need a key. Everything, there is a key to them.
Yes.
Until you have the key, someone will continue to struggle. Until you have the key, it will seem as if you don't know how to do it. Those who have the key will have easy passage. But if you don't have that key, you will be begging. You will be crying. You will be watching. You need that. But the moment you have the key, confidence comes. Confidence comes. You can approach any door when you have the key. You will not struggle. You will not be stagnated. That is why you are going to pray this morning for the key. Even for year 2022. The key to personalities. The key to power. The key to greatness. The key to lifting. The key to success. You need that key. And I will read. I am going to read the book of Matthew before we go into that prayer. The book of Matthew 16, verse 19. 16:19, he said, and I will give unto thee the key of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall remain bound, and whatever you loose shall remain on earth, it shall be loose even in heaven. You are going to lift up your voice and say, Father, the key to year 2022. Give it to me, O Lord. In the name of Jesus. The key, O Lord, for year 2022. Release of man. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. My Father, I pray for that key. The key, O Lord, my God. In the name of Jesus. That is the key that I need to move forward. The key that I need, O Lord, to ascend greater. The key, O Lord, my God, that I need, O Lord, my God, to shame level. The key, O Lord, my God, to the open doors. That is the key. 2022, give it to me. Give it to us in this house. Give us that key, O Lord my God. The key to the heart of man. The key, O Lord my God, to the resources. The key, O Lord my God, to the trials. The key, O Lord my God, to the promotion. The key, O Lord my God, to the lifting. Daddy, I pray. Give us the key. 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 You say you will give it to us. I pray for that key. Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jehovah Jireh, give us that key in the name of Jesus. I pray for that key to the heart of man, to the heart of women, in the name of Jesus, to the heart of Lord my God. That day I pray in the name of Jesus. Give me the key, O Lord my God, to the scripture. That he give it to me, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
You might not value your key until when you lose it. Then you have to be calling around. You need a locksmith, you need this, you need that. And those people will look at you and they will charge you at a very high price. That is why you don't need to get to that level. You have got every key that I've lost in life. Every key that I've been stolen away from me. Every key that the enemy has taken away from me. Father, restore them to me in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Every key, O Lord, may God, that might have lost due to carelessness. Every key that might have been stolen away from you, Lord. Every key, O Lord, may God, that may I pray, O Lord, to spiritual thing, to financial thing, to material thing, whichever key that might have lost. That may I pray, O Lord, may God, restore them. You are the God of restoration. We are in the house of restoration. That may I pray, O Lord, may God, let them be restored. God of restoration, restore the key. The key, O Lord, my God, that give access. The key, O Lord, my God, that they might have lost, that we might have lost in one way or the other. That they are pro, Lord, my God, spiritual key, financial key, material key, marital key, whichever key, that they might have taken away from us, O Lord. That they are pro, Lord, my God, restore them, O Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Sometimes they can give you a bunch of keys, and you might not even know which one opened the door. They can give you a bunch of keys. Then that will throw someone to confusion. So you are going to pray. Show me the key.
Oh, my
Lord, when God showed you the key, say this is the key that opened it. You will not waste your time. You will not be looking here and there. You will not be searching. You just take the key, you put it at the door, and the door open. Lift up your voice, say, Father, show me the key. So year 2022, lift up your voice and begin to pray. That year, pray, Lord, there is a key, O Lord, that open the doors of this year. That is, show it to me, O Lord. Show me the key, 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 the lion of the tribe of Judah, the rose of Sharon, the holy hall, the house of Israel. God, I pray for that key, that access, O Lord, that key, O Lord, that access. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord my God, in the name of Jesus, that is show me the key, Lord. That is show me the key, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. They can show someone the key, but someone might not apply it. You might not have the courage to apply it. The children of Israel, they were by the gates of Jericho for 1 year because they don't know the key. But when God sent his officer, and he showed up and he told them that, look, this is what you will do. I have given you Jericho. I have given you the mighty man of Jericho. But you need this key. What is the key? He said the key is to walk around the wall. He said walk around it. He said you don't need to fight. Just walk around it. And on the seventh day, just shout. That is the key. And when they apply the key, and things happen unto them, you have got to say, confidence to apply the key. Father, give it to me this year. The courage to apply the key. Let your voice and begin to pray. My father, that is the courage, the boldness, the confidence. That is to apply the key this year. That is every key you give to us in the confidence and the courage to apply it to Lord. Give it to Lord. Give it to Lord. Give it to Lord. Give it to Lord. In the name of Jesus, give us that courage. Give us that boldness. Give us that faith. Lord, to apply the key. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. I stand upon the confession of your people, Lord. By the prayer that is being prayed this morning, let there be testimony in the name of Jesus. Every missing key in the life and destiny and home and family of anyone and everyone under the sound of my voice, God of restoration, let them be restored in the name of Jesus. The key that grant access to the wealth of this month, the wealth of this year, that he lets it be given to us in the name of Jesus. The courage, the boldness, that it will take the key and to apply this year, that it gives to everyone under the sound of my voice in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Daddy, for answering our prayers. As we proceed with this, I mean, Daddy, proceed with us. In Jesus' unfailing name, we have prayed. And amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Announcement time. Restoration hour every Monday, 6:45 p.m. to 7:45 p.m. You can join us at the house or online at 425-436-6357. The code is 59799 pound. Reflection hour is every Wednesday, which is 6:45 p.m. to 7:45 p.m. You can also join us in the house or through this number, 425-436-6357, and the code is 59799 pound. Believers Academy is every Sunday between the hour of 9:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. And refreshing hour is every Sunday between the hour of 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Church needs volunteer in children class, choir, and ushering department. If you are interested, you can use any of those numbers to contact us. You can also join us in the house. Please give us a feedback via our email address at restorationb@gmail.com or via these numbers, 443-851-0700 or 667-305-0135. Good morning once again, church.
Good morning. Good morning.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
Praise the living Jesus!
Hallelujah!
Please clap, clap, please clap your hands very well. Clap for Jesus. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Let's go now stand as we sing here our foundation of hymn.
standing on the promises of, Christ my King. No eternal heaven says his praises ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God. Hallelujah.
Standing, 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 standing
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Pray unto the Lord. Say, Father,
Father,
the grace to stand upon your promise that you give unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. The grace to stand upon your promise that you give unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. The promise that cannot fail that you give unto me, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. The grace, O Lord, my God, to stand upon your promise this year that you give unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me that grace, O Lord. 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 Give me the grace in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, I pray that we give us the grace. Give us the grace to stand upon your promises, even this year, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Our Father and our Lord, we bless you this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We worship and we adore your name because you never fail.
Yes.
We thank you because you are ever constant.
Yes.
That it be exalted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We have gathered before you this morning, O Lord, to look at your word. We pray that you will speak to us.
Amen.
Expressly in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Open our eyes that we might see.
Amen.
Open our mind that we might receive.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And as we go to your word, any spirit of confusion, misrepresentation of the word of God, we command them to go into bondage in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Daddy, for answering our prayers. In Jesus' unfailing name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's have a seat. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Once again, you are welcome to the presence of the Lord. And my prayer is that the joy of his presence will not elude you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the special grace of God, our theme for the year and this month is double portion. Double portion, we scratched it a little bit last week, but we want to go deep into it this day, and we are going to go further as God permits us, even in the course of the month, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the special grace of God, what we are considering is the keys to double portion. The keys to double portion. As I told us in the first prayer that we pray, is that to everything in life, there is key. There is key. Because you don't have it, that doesn't mean it does not exist. There is key. As long as there is a door, there is a key. And when you find it, people will think that you are smart. People that will think that you know how to do it. Not only that you know how to do it, it's just that you found the key. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And those who doesn't find it will continue to struggle and struggle and struggle. So that is how it is in life. God wired this world with the keys. And so that is why it is a very good and important prayer to pray that God give me the key. Pray that prayer every day. Every day, as you step out, they have their own key. Every hour, have their own key. Because things happen not just suddenly. It happens per hour. It happens per minute. It happens per seconds. It happens per day. There is a key to the door. Bible says there is a window of heaven. So if there is a window, that means there is a key. If there is a door to heaven, there is a key to it too. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This year is a year of double portion. You will have it in the mighty name of Jesus. But I want us to be armed with the knowledge that there is a key to it. And God will give you that key in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's look at the book of 2 Kings, which is our anchor scripture. We have a lot of scripture to read this morning, so I want to prepare our mind ready. We have it on the screen. 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 9. We are going to read it together. 1, 2, 3, go. And it came to pass, when they were gone over, that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee, before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. You will get double this year in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Not everyone, not many people in the Bible have that blank check. Only few people have that access. Solomon was one of them, and Elisha was one of them. Blank check. That whatever you have is going to come to, but not many people have that opportunity. And God is giving it to you this year in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He's going to present a blank check and tell you that write whatever you want on it. That is what God will do for you this year in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All those years of waste, all those years of struggling, God is ruling them out of your life. You have just begun to live your dream in the mighty name of Jesus. And in this year, you are going to live your dream in the name of Jesus. The key is the answer to the closed doors.
Yes,
and for a specific door to be open, you must identify the key to it and apply it. So it is not enough for someone to just know the key. You must apply. There are a lot of people that know the key. When you tell them, say, I know it, I've heard about it 10 years ago. I know it 5 years ago. But the question is, why is it that your life has not changed? Why? Because they have not applied it. They know the key, but they don't apply. So it is not enough for you to know the key as in applying the key. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And this year you will apply the key.
Amen.
And it will work for you.
Amen.
I said that is why we want to explore the key to double portion in year 2022. Very, very timely message. It is timely because you need it. And the key we want to consider today, it is attitude.
Hallelujah.
Attitude. I say attitude, determine your altitude. Your attitude to life will determine how far and how high you can rise. Attitude can either be positive or negative. If you have positive attitude, there is tendency that you will move forward. If you have negative attitude to life, someone's life can be stagnated or retrogressing. Retrograding, that sounds about will be going backward. You will not go backward this year.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not go down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your life will not go backward in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said it is the attitude that make people to have similar experiences but different results. Attitude. Different, the same experience but different results. It is attitude that made that difference. And that difference that the world is waiting for, God is going to give it to you this year in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So today we want to show, we are choosing the life of Joseph as a case study.
Hallelujah.
And we want to look at his life and see how the attitude of Joseph make a difference in his entire career, in his entire life. Attitude. And if you can follow what I am going to preach or what I'm going to say today, your life will never be average. I'm telling you, there is nothing you want that will not come to you. Because this is a master key. It works in anywhere. It works in any career. It works in family. It works in the church. It works anywhere. Attitude matters. I said it determines your altitude. Attitude determines altitude. I mean a positive attitude. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Joseph's attitude, his positive attitude, makes him to be loved by his father and God. And I want us to look at the book of Genesis chapter 37, and I want somebody to help us read verse 2, possibly verse 3. We have a lot of scripture because
we are
going
to... These are the generations of Jacob.
These are the generations of Jacob.
Joseph being 17 years old.
Joseph being 17 years old.
With
he was feeding flock with his brethren.
And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah.
He was with the sons of the Bilhah.
And the son of the Zilpah.
And the son of Zilpah.
His father's wives.
His father's wives.
And Joseph brought unto his father their
what did he bring? Report. He brought unto his father there was evil reports.
Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his
children. His father loved him more than all his children. That's okay, man. Let's stop there. He loved him more than all his children. Why? Because he hated evil. You cannot give report of evil people. Well, I said, you are not part of it. That is why some politicians, they cannot come out and talk boldly because they are part of it. That's why there are some religious leaders, they can't come out and speak against the evil thing that goes on in the land. Why? Because they are part. Praise the Lord. The Bible said that he gave evil report. Why? He doesn't love evil. That's one of his first attitude. He hated evil. And because of that, his father loved him. And not only his father, God loved him too. So, he wins the love of God and that of his father. I said, positive attitude, it attracts the love of God and the love of good people. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
His father is the only one in that house that has authority over his life, not his brother. And as long as he won the love of that man and that of God, how do you know that God loved him? God gave him dream. Not just one, he gave him two dreams. Two important dreams. Because God looked at his attitude. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, I was wondering, I was saying, how come? Because by the birthright, Joseph is not qualified for double portion. Because he wasn't the firstborn of his father. In fact, he was not the second. He was not the third, the fourth, fifth, and sixth. He doesn't have that position. He was the first son of his mother, rather, anyway, but he's not the first son of his father. And it is the firstborn that's supposed to have access to the double portion. But how did he get it? Even Judah did not get double portion. Judah, whose name means praise, whose God said is going to be the king, whose Bible said that the scepter of leadership will not depart from his house, he doesn't get it. Why? Because of his positive attitude. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
David came from the tribe of Judah. They are the one that produced the king in Israel. But Joseph's attitude made him to get what he don't even deserve. So your positive attitude can take you far this year. It is not what happens to you that matters, but how you reacted to it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There are things that people will do to you intentionally. They want to see your reaction. There may be certain positions that are waiting ahead, and they want to see whether you have the character to handle it, to manage it. They will put certain things to you. Certain things that they know that human being will never take. Nobody that have in his good sense will ever take it. They will push that thing to you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They want to test your character. And the moment someone fails, they will say, no, it's not qualified. I pray this year you will be more than qualified in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, I say, just a positive attitude made him hate evil things. That is, his brethren does and reported it to his father. He made him hate evil things. You must hate evil, hate sin. Don't play with sin this year. Sin suppress someone's life. Sin, it makes someone to be at the back. Sin is stagnate someone's life. And if you look at the life of Joseph, Joseph run away from sin. The mother, the wife of his master, the wife of his mother, the wife of Potiphar would have stagnated his life. But Joseph ran away. Now, it was in that when I was meditating, I said that is the reason why God did not choose Reuben. Because that will be the end of Reuben. Somebody that slept with his father's wife. Is he going to see anything bad in sleeping with his mother's wife? No. So that was the reason why God didn't choose him or Judah. Because these are the two key guys. Judah that slept with his son's wife. Isn't the one that we not see that we see something that is bad? Sleeping with his master's wife? No. So God looks at us and he looks at someone's attitude. God looks at someone that has the character that can handle certain things. Or Levite and Simeon. Levite and Simeon, the two of them are brothers. And somebody raped their sister, the only daughter of Jacob, Dinah. They raped her. And they went with their hunger. They went into the entire city and they wiped out all the men. Somebody that have the problem with anger, somebody that have problem with unforgiveness, do you think it can be that Joseph whom they treated like that, that will not revenge? No. So God bypassed them. So if you don't have one good thing to bypass you this year, choose positive attitude. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There are some friends that will disappoint you. I won't lie to you. There are some people that you really trust that will walk away from you when you needed them. But don't close the door against them. You can need them tomorrow. Don't because somebody is bad today and you put him in the blacklist. No. Give allowance to each other's faults. Because you too, you are not perfect too. I am not perfect. Nobody is perfect. Be positive this year. And you will see how things will turn around for you. You will see how things will work for you this year. Make sure you run away from the evil. Number three, I said Joseph was hated by his brethren, but he did not allow their hatred to change his love for them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because he knew that they hated him. Somebody read verse 5 to verse 8. I said we want to really look at the life of Joseph. The book of Genesis 37, 5 to 8, yes.
And Joseph dreamed a dream.
He dreamt a dream.
And he told it to his brethren.
He told it to his brethren.
And they hated him yet the more.
They hated him the more.
And he said unto them.
And he said unto them.
Then I pray you.
Can you don't let us leave that because you have a lot of things to do. Somebody that hated you, is it the same person you go and share your dream with? Huh? They will be the last person to share your dream with. But their hatred doesn't affect his love. Anytime, love wins. Anytime. Hatred and love, whenever they compete, love will always win. Bible says that love, multitude of love, covereth all sins. Multitude of sins. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, he didn't allow their hatred. He didn't allow it to change. It's love for them. Don't allow people's hatred to change who you are. If they succeeded in changing who you are, that means that you are not real. You are not real. Some people say that I used to be this, but now when people are, that means you are not real. That is not who you are. That is not who you are. Don't allow people's wickedness to change who you are, and don't be stupid. Rather, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
For I said Joseph suffered for what he did not do, yet he didn't allow it to change his positive attitude. Can somebody look at the book of Genesis 39, verse 19 for us? Genesis 39. He suffered for what he did not do. They lied against him. His wife, his master's wife, lied and they put him in prison. But he didn't allow him to change.
That he called unto the men of the house.
Yes.
And spake unto them.
And spake unto them.
And see.
Yes.
He has brought in an Hebrew unto us.
Dusna woman is a racist.
To mock us.
She said Hebrew. Racist woman. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who knows? Whether she don't even want Joseph to sleep with him. Maybe she even want to set herself up. Because at that background, Joseph was rising. Everything was good for Joseph. And he was saying, come and lie with me. Who knows whether she don't even want Joseph to lie with her, that she wants to finish Joseph. Because most of the time, we always think that, oh, she's this and that. She want what? Who knows? If Joseph tried and he now yelled, set up. But Joseph ran away. Praise the Lord. But he didn't allow it to shake. Number 5. I said Joseph's positive attitude attract God and retain his presence with him. Let's look at the book of Genesis chapter 39, verse 2 and verse 21. Genesis 39, 2 and verse 21.
And the Lord was with Joseph.
And Lord was with Joseph.
And he was a prosperous man.
If you want to enjoy the divine presence of God this year, you must have positive attitude towards life. If you want God to be with you, you want to carry his presence, his tangible presence this year, please, I'm begging you, have positive attitude towards life. Bible said that he attracted the presence of God. Not only that he attracted it, he retained it as well. So if you want to enjoy 365 days of divine presence, positive attitude is the key. Number 6, I said Joseph's positive attitude make people see God in him. Genesis 39, verse 3. Can somebody read that one for us quickly?
And his master saw that the Lord
was what?
Was with him.
Was with him.
And that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his
hand. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can they see your God? If you want them to see God in you this year, positive attitude. But if you are wicked, they do something to you, you do it back. They do this to you, you fire back. Nobody will see your God. Because they will see that's normal. Because the wicked, they do the same thing. The politicians love their own, right? Yes. The unbeliever, they love their own. Drunkard, they love their own. They do good to those who do good to them. So how are you going to see God in that situation? God can only be seen in our life when we choose to be different. That's why you say, what is so special about you? We try everything, yet you never change. praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So this year I want you to make up your mind that I want them to see Jesus in me, in my character, in my behavior, in what I do this year. I want to showcase. I don't even want only my words to preach Jesus. I want my character. I want my behavior. I want to preach Jesus even this very year. And the best place to preach it is in your place of work. Because most of all, you spend most of your hours in the place of work. Some of us, 16 hours, we are there. Some of us, all days, we are there. You only go to home maybe to sleep and to eat. How are they going to see it in your place of work, where you spend most of your time? Let them see that Christ in you. Show it unto them by your character. The master, the boss of Joseph, he saw it. Positive attitude. And what did he do? When they notice that you have God, they will commit better things to your hand, because nobody wants it to get lost. Nobody. If they know that they put this in, you'll be surprised how your boss is giving you a lot of responsibility, because they have seen something in you that they can't, they don't see in others. If you are trustworthy, you are faithful, you are loyal, when you say yes, you mean yes. When you say no, you mean no. They will respect you and they will give you responsibility. And the more responsibility you have, the more pay you receive. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Number 8, I said, Joseph attitude. No, number 7, I said, Joseph positive attitude made him carrier of grace, mercy, and favor. Can somebody look at the book of Genesis 39, 4 and verse 21? 4 and 21. Yes.
And Joseph found grace.
And Joseph found grace.
And he served him.
In a serving.
And he made him. Him overseer over his house.
He found grace in the sight of his master, and he made him overseer over his house. Verse 21.
Okay.
Again, 4:21 is similar.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
But God was with Joseph.
And showed him mercy.
And he showed him mercy.
And gave him favor.
And gave him favor
in the sight of the keeper.
In the sight of the keeper. Do you see the difference now? That's what positive. If you know you are struggling for favor of somebody, turn it around with positive attitude. Positive attitude will make you to connect favor everywhere. It will make mercy to locate you. You won't fight. It will not even be your prayer anymore. Because you will have that mercy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You become the carrier of grace, mercy, and favor. 8. I said, Joseph's positive attitude made his work prosperous and blessed. Let's look at that same book of Genesis 39, 3b and verse 23. 3b and verse 23.
And that the Lord made all the
deed
to prosper.
Bible says he made it to prosper. Why? Because of his positive attitude. Positive attitude, yes?
And Joseph found grace in his sight.
He found grace in his sight.
And he served him.
And he served him.
And made him overseer of all his house.
Yes. That verse 23.
23, no.
Go to 23.
The keeper of the prison looked to anything that was.
He looked not to anything. Yes.
That was under his hand.
That's complete trust.
Because the Lord was with him.
Because God was with him.
And that which he did, the Lord made it to prosper.
That is just it. Positive attitude brings prosperity. If you have positive attitude, you will discover that everything you lay your hand upon will prosper. You will always see the second side of things. You won't see things the way everybody sees it. You will see things differently. And what people celebrate is the way you see things. The difference in you. The difference in your talk, in your dressing, in work, in the way you do things. That is what people pay for. That is what is being rewarded in the market, out there in the market. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I said, Joseph's positive attitude made him a blessing to the people around him. You want to be a blessing? Your positive attitude. Look at people that have positive attitude. They attracted more friends. You become blessing to people. When they have issues, you are the first they call. Even their private life, they can share it with you. But there are some people that, even upon all the anointing and the grace, they won't be able to share anything with them. your positive attitude. And that was what made Joseph to move from prison to palace. Positive attitude. He noticed, they didn't even tell him the story. He noticed the countenance of the sheep of land, the sheep of land, that was not his character. It's not the way it used to be. And he said, what is wrong? And they said, we have a problem with our dream. He said, interpretation belongs to God. Tell it to me and let's look at it together. Positive attitude. It brought joy. It lightened their world. It lightened their life. Can people miss you when you leave a particular place? It is positive attitude towards it. And with your positive attitude, people will respect you because they don't know what you will do. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I have found myself in that situation on several occasions. I have a couple of friends that they are afraid of me. Because what they expected someone to do, ordinarily because of what they have done to, they expected it, but I disappointed them. Because they do evil, and they thought I'm going to repay them back in their evil coins, I walk away. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You choose your fight in life. There are things that doesn't matter. Positive attitude. It makes people to respect you. That's why Jesus said that even when your enemy is hungry, he said, feed him. How can you feed your enemy? David found Saul in a place where he could have killed Saul. He only cut his garment and walked away. And he called him and said, Saul, God give me the privilege to kill you. Saul said, you sure? And he said, see, how did I cut this? And Saul said to him, the book of Samuel, we won't have time to go there. And Saul said to him that, how can somebody found his enemy and still let him go? How come? Positive attitude. Positive attitude. It's a key. It's a master key. It might be tough at the beginning, but it works. I've tried it many times. It worked for me. And if you try this year, it's going to work for you too. Positive attitude. Then I said, Joseph, positive attitude, bring in promotion everywhere he goes. That is what we do. If you desire promotion this year, have positive attitude towards things. Towards things. Things happen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Things happen. You cannot always want everything to go your way. Amen.
Amen.
Positive attitude. It makes someone to be promoted. Joseph got he got to the house of Potiphar as a slave. Within a short period of time, he became the overseer. Not many people bear that very title, overseer. He got to the prison, the man looked at him as well. He makes him the overseer too, because he's different. And look, he doesn't have paper. You know he doesn't have paper? He's not a citizen of Egypt. He entered there as a slave. But his positive attitude turned things around. Because of his positive attitude, they don't even look at his paper, whether he has it or not. When he got to the palace, nobody asked the question, do you have paper or you don't have paper? What did they see? Positive attitude. The solution that he brought on the table. I pray this year, the Almighty God will promote you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Quickly, I said, where do you need to express positive attitude this year? And this is why we have a lot of scripture to read. Number one, your family. Positive attitude towards your family member. Who are your family? Your immediate family, your extended family, your brothers, your sisters. Be positive toward them this year. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus. Genesis 45 from verse 3. Genesis 45 from verse 3.
And Joseph said unto his brethren,
yes,
I am Joseph.
Did
my father yet live?
Is my father still live?
And his brethren could not answer.
They said they cannot answer him.
For they were troubled.
They were troubled because they don't believe he's still alive. They were so troubled because they believe he's going to die. In fact, in their record, Joseph is late. So when he said, I am Joseph, they said, you must not. I don't think you are right. I don't think you are okay. He said, I am Joseph, it's my father's here. When he was asking them some classified information, they know that this is true Joseph. The Bible said they were afraid. Imagine if Joseph at his presence, imagine if Joseph were to be Simeon and Levi at that particular time. What do you think will happen? They will die immediately. He will kill every one of them. Brethren, this year, show mercy. It makes your enemy to respect you more.
and it makes them to fear you more. This is then they will know that you are serving a living God.
Know that injury?
His brother, they never recover from it. Even after their father died many years, they say, come back, Joseph is going to revenge. Joseph said, am I in the place of God? I will take care of you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number two, your in-laws. Be positive towards your in-law. Time may not permit us to read that because my time is fast spent. Ruth, he took care of Naomi. There were two people there, Ruth and Orpah. Maybe we should just read. Then look at the book of Ruth, chapter 1, verse 8, to verse 16, rather. Ruth 1, 8 to 16. Naomi told her, he said unto her,
two daughter-in-law.
There are two daughters-in-law.
So return each to her mother.
He said, return to your mother's place.
May the Lord be kindly with me.
May the Lord be kindly with me.
As you have dealt with the dead.
Yes.
And with me.
Yes.
The Lord grant you that you may find rest.
Yes.
Each of you in the house of her husband.
Oh, yes.
Then she kissed them.
Yes.
And they lifted up their voices.
They lifted up. They did. You see, they are still doing the same thing now. Yes, continue.
And they said unto her. Surely we will return to thee.
We will not go. We are going to stay with you.
Unto thy people.
Yes.
And now be said.
I want you to follow this thing carefully. Yes.
Turn again. My daughters. Why will you go with me? Is there yet any more son in my womb?
That can be your husband?
Turn again, my daughters. Go your way. I am too old to have an husband.
Hopeless situation. Yes.
If I should say. I have hope. If I should have an husband. Also tonight.
I shall bear a son tonight.
Will you wait for them to get to maturity?
Yes.
Will you stay for them from having husband?
Yes.
Nay, my daughter.
For it grieved me much for your sake.
That the hand of God has gone against you. And they lifted up their voices.
And wept again.
And Oprah kissed her. Keep her mother-in-law.
She kissed her mother-in-law.
But Ruth cleaved unto her.
Even against all hope.
And she said, no hope.
Yes, continue.
And she said.
Your sister-in-law.
She has gone back to her people
and her God.
And unto her God.
Yes.
Returned back to that God. And Ruth said.
He says, insist me not to leave you.
Or to return after thee. For without thou goest.
He said, where you go?
I will go.
And where thou lodgest?
I will lodge.
Thy people shall be my people.
And thy God my God.
Determination. Positive attitude. Even when you don't see any benefit, no reward. Is there any reward?
No.
She said, I will still follow you.
Did it end well?
Yes. The story ended well. And I am praying your story this year will end well.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The way you started this year is not the way you are going to end it.
Amen.
You are going to end it in a better way.
Amen.
In a great way.
Amen.
In a glorious way.
Amen.
In a unique way.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I have about 9, but we will not be able to go over it. Maybe we continue next week. We will not be able to go over it. There are about 8 different areas whereby you need to apply positive attitude. Positive attitude towards your neighbor. Positive attitude. You don't know your neighbor. You don't know who they know. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You don't know who I know. I may not have money, but I may know people that have the money. I may know people that have the connection that can make your life. If you root to me, I may just walk there when at the time of your opportunity. And they will ask me a question. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Be positive to your neighbor. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me quickly go over it because we may not be able to have this issue. We are going to have something else next week by the grace of God. I said, strangers. Be positive towards strangers. Should look at the book of Hebrews 13, verse 2. 5. Be positive towards God. The book of 1 Samuel 2:30. God said, whosoever that honor me, I will honor. Whosoever that dishonor me, don't dishonor God this year. Please, in any way, don't dishonor God. Be positive. Even when things does not even go well, don't let God be number last or second. Make him first this year. And you are going to see God will make you first. Everywhere you go, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say even to God's people, I would have liked God to read this, but the time doesn't permit us. Eli, he looked at Anna. Anna was praying. Anna, somebody prayed in the house of God. And you said, she's a drunkard. Positive attitude. Anna would have missed it there. Because authority is in the mouth of Eli. How can she miss to be many of her sisters of nowadays? Say, Pastor, I expected you to have vision now. Don't you know the difference between someone that is drunkard and someone that is praying? You know that we insult him. They will abuse him. And Eli said that, let it be to you according to desire. And that sealed it. Positive attitude.
You are in the world of the world. And when I say, watch what come out of your mouth. Three things matters: your mouth, your tongue, and your word. The three of them, they work together for your success. So let's be careful how we throw it this year. Be careful how you open your mouth. There are times whereby you just have to close the mouth and walk away. Because what you say, sometimes they can use it against you. But that will never be our portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said, even towards your enemy this year, be positive. Be positive. You want to win the game. Because that's what confused them. That's the way Jesus wants us to fight. That's what confused them. When they hate you and you show them love, they get confused. Because they don't know where you are going to strike.
Somebody slap you and you just walk away. He doesn't know whether you want to go and carry gun or you want to go and carry cutlass. It will be what? But if he slap you and you slap your own back, say yes. Everything in one, everything settled.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Even towards your friend. Bible says, so that I have friends, they must be friendly. Shall we rise up on our feet?
Mm-hmm. I want to rise up on your feet this year. And you are going to pray that, Father, give me positive attitude this year.
But what's anything and everything that will come my way? Lord, give me, oh Lord, my God, the grace, oh Lord. Give me, oh Lord, my God, the strength, oh Lord. Give me the power to stand, oh Lord, my God. In the name of Jesus, the positive attitude to see things differently, not to see it in the worldly fashion from the worldly view. Give me, oh Lord, my God, the grace, oh Lord. Father, give it to me, oh Lord. Give me, oh Lord. Give me, oh Lord, my God, the positive attitude towards life, towards situation, oh my God. Even when my neighbor, even when my family doesn't disturb me, oh Lord, my God. Daddy, give me, oh Lord, my God, that very grace, that very power, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
I want to give opportunity to as many that has not known the Lord. You may want to try it, but it won't work without Jesus. You need Jesus to be positive. And Jesus is the only one that can help you. If you want to accept him today, I want you to surrender your life unto him. And Jesus can give you that positive attitude towards life. I want you to say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I have come before you tonight, today, and I want you, oh Lord, to be my Lord. I want you to be my Savior. I did I forsake my sin today. I want to wipe it out, and I want to write my name in the book of life. And today, Lord, I choose you as my Savior. Be my Savior forever. And if I go to call the righteous in, call me even along with the righteous in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Daddy, we have spoken the word, oh Lord. And I pray everywhere the word has been spoken. Daddy, people have had the word, and I pray this word you water it.
Amen.
In the heart of everyone, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As many that receive today, write their name in the book of life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I pray, oh Lord, my God, if you are calling the righteous in tonight, Daddy, count every one of us worthy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
A positive attitude towards life. Daddy, this year, give for us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we are stepping out there to apply this key, let the key work for us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every part that we make this key not to work for you, work for me, let them be wasted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Daddy, because you have answered our prayers. In Jesus' unfailing name, we have prayed.
Amen.
and amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It is offering time.
Blessing time.
Blessing time.
Offering time.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, shaking together. So it's time to give unto the Lord our quality offerings, our tithes, and whatever the Lord has asked us to give towards his ministry. And the Lord will bless us mightily.
Amen.
Amen.
Please give us.
Osoba bire, osibaba bire, omasola rubire. Osoba bire, laye akoru, omasola rubire. Igwe.
May their actions be highly rewarded in the name of
Amen.
Jesus. Father Lord, give us a wonderful and marvelous day.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting.
Thank you, Jesus.
You have answered us, for we have asked and prayed in Jesus'
name. Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Before we go, I want us to remember tomorrow we are going to meet here at 6:45 p.m. It's going to be restoration hour, and the time is the help maker. The help maker. As many of us that can make it, I want to come here because it's going to be serious. We want to pray for help. If the help you need this year is not available, God will create it.
Amen.
That is our purpose of coming. The help maker, you can share it with your friend. Is there? Share it with your friends, share it with your family. Even if you care about your enemy, share it with them as well. The help maker. The Bible says that Adam, there was no help for Adam, and God created one for him. This year, God must create help for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any help that you lack, God will create it for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So let's come 6:45 p.m. tomorrow. Let's come and pray. And it's going to be serious. Say it is going to be serious.
It's going to be serious.
In the name of Jesus. Ask something from God before we go. Ask something from God. Ask something from God. If I'm to be you, I will ask for help. That this week, let there be an angelic help. Let there be an angelic assistance for me. Let the angel of help, let him visit me. This week, oh Lord my God, I schedule anyone, oh Lord my God, that will make life difficult for me. Schedule them in will, Lord my God, from my route. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let the weather work for me. Let the land work for me. Let the season work for me. Let the day, let the hour, let everything in this week, let them work for my good in the name of Jesus. Let them cooperate with my health in the name of Jesus. This week, whatever I set my hand upon, that it cause it to prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the fear, Lord my God, of this world, let it not, oh Lord my God, find its way in my life, in my home, in this house, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the hand of God be upon our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be well with us in all that we say, in all that we do, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Our Father, we want to bless you because you are God.
Yes,
we appreciate and worship you because there is no one like you.
Yes.
That it be exalted in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Daddy, we have come, O Lord my God, before you. Daddy, and we have fellowship before you. And Daddy, and we are living now. Daddy, we don't want to live, O Lord my God, into darkness, but we are still living into your presence. Let your presence guide us through, O Lord my God. How this week, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever we set our hands and our mind to do, cause them to prosper, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everywhere we turn this week, let there be way for us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This week you will not fall.
Amen.
I will not fall.
Amen.
We will not fall.
Amen.
We will not falter.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every snare of the wicked, every trap that might have set for you in anywhere, in any area, I command fire to go ahead of you and consume them. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This week you will not be a victim.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will be a victor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will be well with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever that is going out there in the here, it will not catch you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not fall victim of it. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree sound mind and sound health to every member from this house and as many that are connected with us right now. Let there be sound mind, sound health for everyone. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree the hand of God to journey with you and high. This week in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the hand make a way.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This week it shall be easy for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall be easy for me.
Amen.
It shall be easy for us.
Amen.
In this house, in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be.
Amen.
Anyone that rises against you will fall for your sin.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every enemy that walk against you will walk for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Redeemer. Whatever
that
belongs unto you this week, I command it to be released unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No good thing will be denied, even you of, in the mighty name
Amen.
Of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' unfailing name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Let's say the grace together.
Amen.
In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let somebody shout, Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
joining us. God bless you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
See you tomorrow at the restoration hour, 6:45 p.m. God bless you in the name of Jesus.